is making headlines. It's Tuesday, November 29th, 2011, and thanks for joining us today.
I'm Aaliyah, and with me today is Markella, and on today's show, we'll look at what you won't want to touch when you head to the mall for shopping, as well as where you want to be this Saturday to support an Oak Crest event.
That's right. We've got those stories and more, including a national news story about what one woman actually did to get the front of the line to get this year's hottest video games on Black Friday. Now for other info and to watch past episodes, visit us right here on our YouTube channel.
On the Falcon TV News YouTube channel, you can watch past episodes and also view videos not featured on our show. Our channel is updated daily, and you can find a link on our Oak Crest webpage.
Comments or to submit stories to our show, email us at falcontv@talentproductions.yahoo.com or visit us on Twitter to get that info to us. Our email address is at the bottom of the screen. All right, take a look at that health story about what not to touch at the mall while shopping.
Start off with what you need to know when you start your holiday shopping this week. A recent report released now has the dirt on the top five germiest places in the mall.
That's right. During the craziness of the holidays, the last thing you want is to get sidelined with a cold, flu, stomach bug, or worse. But while you're checking items off your shopping list, you may be exposed yourself to germs, like flu viruses, E. coli, and staph. That can make you sick.
A panel of experts loosely ranked the worst germ hotspots at your local shopping center. Here are the rankings. Starting with number 5 is toy stores. ATM keypads come in at number 4. And number 3 is escalators. The number 2 position is held by the food court tables.
And at number 1, it's the mall bathroom, but not the toilet handle or the doorknob. It's the sink. Bacteria includes E. coli, fester in the faucets and handles because people touch those surfaces right after using the toilet. So when you're out shopping for gifts over the next couple of weeks, be on the lookout for the hidden deals and the hidden germs.
Now, for some club and meeting info, remember, if you are in a club or in an advisor of one, you can email us your info to our email address, talentproductions@yahoo.com.
In upcoming events, over the past 2 weeks, we've been bringing you clips of last year's lip sync concert to get you ready for the big show being held on December 2nd, right here in the Oak Crest Auditorium. A Bunch of Talents has unique acts came out to audition, and the final roster of talent has been selected, so be sure to come out to this year's show to support your fellow Falcons and see who wins. Here's another look at the last year's performance.
Clubs and meetings, the GAA will have a meeting today. All female athletes should plan on being in attendance on the 29th with Ms. Delaranga.
If you want to join the Oak Crest cheerleading team, make sure you come out for this year's tryouts. Get a physical and turn it in to the nurse and mark November 29th, 30th, and December 1st on your calendar.
Tryouts will be held in the Blue Gym on those dates from 6 to 8 p.m., but you need to have your physical cleared first. If you don't have a physical form, get one from the athletic director's office, and if you have any questions, email them at oakcrestcheer@gmail.com.
Collecting stuffed animals, coats, hats, gloves, scarves, or toys for the tots in their various holiday drives taking place right now.
If you're interested in helping those fortunate, bring those items to the PE office if you want to help out. You can do your part by helping out those in need the most this holiday season. The GAA also continued the tradition of the Giving Tree.
Coming up this weekend, the dance team is once again sponsoring their annual Christmas craft show. Recently, reporter Elias Malls caught up with the organizer of the event, dance teacher Miss Gaskell, to find out what's coming up on Saturday right here at the Oakcrest Cafeteria.
Hello, I'm reporter Elias Malls here live at the dance studio with information about the dance craft that will be held on December 3rd in the cafeteria. Here with me today is Miss Gaskell with the information. It sure looked like a great event, but in the science club, it's still selling Ron's Wetzel-friendly bags, but time is running out. They're made of recycled materials and make a great gift or a great way to carry your gifts while they're shopping. They're $5 and you can collect from four different styles.
They feature four different green designs. If you wanted to pick one up, you can get one from Miss Baker in room 419 or from a science club member for only $5.
Going on right now, the Social Studies Club is still sponsoring a Women's Center client holiday charity donation drive. They're looking for new, unused donation toys of clothes, gifts, and things that can be given this holiday season. If you're interested in getting involved, stop down to see Ms. Darrow or Mr. Sarah in room 223.
And finally, over at the William Davies Middle School, right down the road, giving has also taken place in the form of donation. Gym classes for the Dragons has changed. Thanks to a recent Tilt and Fitness donation of several pieces of workout equipment for the school's physical education classes. The donations include Life Fitness bikes, step machines, a bicep and tricep machine, and a lat row machine.
Tickets for this year's show will be available for the purchase ahead of time during lunches and from the sophomore classes at Vajra, so stay tuned in for that information.
For some more national news, last week marked the official kickoff of the holiday shopping season and ended with a Southern California woman turned herself in to authorities as the person who pepper sprayed video game shoppers in the Walmart during Black Friday's shopping frenzy.
That woman has not been charged because detectives are continuing in their investigation that the incident required firefighters to treat 10 people for the exposure of pepper spray.
The pepper spraying incident, which occurred in a Walmart, wasn't the only place where shoppers got out of hand. Black Friday shoppers was marked by the violence in at least 7 other states. Stay safe out there from the germs and the other shoppers.
And finally, don't forget to keep voting in the Under Armour Finding Undeniable contest. There are only 4 days left and we've jumped up to 8th position. Oakcrest could win over $140,000 worth of gear. Cast your vote at www.findingundeniable.com or follow the link to Facebook where you can vote for Oakcrest.
All right, I'm here with Mr. Servi. He's leading Oakcrest in the Under Armour Finding Undeniable contest. And Mr. Servi, how can the students vote and how are we doing right now?
Right now, we're 11. We have 3,000 points that we're going to be done today. That'll bring us up to probably 7. If we move up to 7, we're in the top 10. We then can be one of the wild card teams. The first two teams will get stuff. We're hoping for the wild card. A lot of you have seen the video. They were very much impressed with that video. The way that you can vote is to go to findingunderarmor.com, go to Oakcrest High School, click on your Facebook page, and you vote. Vote now, early, often, and as many times as you can. You get your aunts, uncles, grandparents, great-grandparents, little cousins in first grade, anybody that has a Facebook page, they can vote. And then we'll get stuff. It'll be pretty cool.
All right, thank you very much. So remember, people, if you have Facebook, go online and vote, 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 Oakcrest, and let's get back in this.
We completed almost all the challenges and need the online votes to keep climbing up the charts. As long as we finish in the top 10, we still get something. So make sure you participate and help out the Oakcrest community.
Don't forget to visit Twitter and follow OHS Falcon TV for Oakcrest news and club meeting info.
And you can visit us on Falcon TV website for the latest updates on everything Oakcrest, including links to videos and events and the Oakcrest and in the community.
That was your news for Tuesday, and thanks for watching today. For Markella and everyone else here at the Falcon TV studio, we'll see you back here tomorrow. I'm Aaliyah, and this is Falcon TV News. Have a great day.
Ram.
Yes.
Yay.